At the heart of State of Decay 2, you've got this management simulation. It's what makes State of Decay 2 different than other zombie games because, you know, A Dying Light and Dead Island and Left 4 Dead, they don't have building a base, they don't have recruiting people into the community, and they don't have stuff like, you know, deciding what facilities you want to build to make the ultimate base, and they don't have, like, you know, poring over the stats on the community members, positive and negative traits, what skills do you want, which skills do you not want to make the ultimate base with the ultimate community. That's what makes State of Decay different than many of the other zombie games out there. What drives me nuts about Undead Labs is that they focus their efforts on, like, cosmetic things, like, basically weapon reskins. Even Providence Ridge is, like, mostly cosmetic with the exception of the new heavy weapons. And as a result, you've got this problem where there are core fundamental elements of the game. In this case, I want to talk about specifically craftsmanship, but it is one of several things in the game that are just falling behind. And they're really important to the game. And so what I want to talk about is why it's so important for fifth skills to be at least decent. They can't be bad. And we're specifically going to use craftsmanship as our example. I want to talk about why is craftsmanship bad and how Undead Lab is actually making it worse. And finally, what can we do to make craftsmanship a better skill? So why is it a problem? Why is it so bad for a fifth skill to be in such a poor condition? Well, the way you can tell that fifth skills are really vital to the game is because they're really the first qualifier or disqualifier when recruiting somebody. You think about it. When you recruit somebody, and let's say you don't care about the character's appearance, the first thing you look at is what fifth skill they have, if any at all. Because if they have a fifth skill that you don't want, that immediately disqualifies them because, well, you can't remove or alter a fifth skill once they have it. You can only add it to them if they don't have a fifth skill at all. So, I mean, the fact that that just instantaneously disqualifies a character if they don't have the skill you want just shows you how important it is. Like, forget the idea that, like, oh, you needed to build up your base. You know, you need, like, knowledge of medicine to get to the level 3 infirmary for, strong painkillers. But it's just the fact that they disqualify so quickly that it just shows how integral, how vital fifth skills are. And here's the problem. If there's a fifth skill that's bad, well, then that means that you immediately don't want that character because, you know, you just recognize that, hey, this is not a skill I'm ever going to use. And as a result, I just never would ever want you. You're just not good. And that's why it's really important for at least the core fifth skills, which are the ones that can level up and be promoted. None of them can be bad. They don't have to be amazing, but they have to at least be decent. I think if you have a primary fifth skill that is, like, really bad, like you just would never want it, that's a really big problem, and it's something that needs to be addressed. And the game's going, like, 2 years old, and craftsmanship, it honestly has always been bad. And that's really the next part I want to talk about, is what makes craftsmanship so bad? Well, craftsmanship from the very beginning of the game, I consider it a very misguided skill. And that's because it doesn't solve any important problems. The reason you want a fifth skill is because you got a problem and you want to fix it. For example, your problem is you don't have enough influence. So how do you get it? Well, you need to get chemistry to get pharmacology, and you need medicine because you need to unlock level 3 infirmary. Then you can get the strong painkillers, and now you've solved a very important problem. And it was a very interactive solution because, well, you need three things. You need chemistry, medicine, and then someone needs to be a trader so you can build a trade depot so that you could, you know, sell effectively. That really sets up the combo. But think about it there. We just had to go through different skills, and that's interactive. That made you thought about it. You were looking for specific people, or you might have gone to loot specific areas where you suspect you can find training manuals. And going back to craftsmanship, it just doesn't solve any problems. So to address this, what does craftsmanship do? Well, it's probably easier to talk about the two advanced skills, and this is one of the problems right off the bat. Both of craftsmanship's advanced skills are bad. Some skills have one really good one and then one not so good one. A good example is mechanics. Auto mechanics is really good, and engineering is, it's really not that great. But even worse, mechanics is really good right off the bat. If mechanics did nothing else but unlock the ability to make repair kits, it would still be really good because it's solving a very important problem. Hey, I need to repair my car, especially on Nightmare Zone where cars fall apart very easily. That alone, even if mechanics did nothing else, it would still be really good. So what does craftsmanship do? Well, at the base level, it allows you to access the forge. And I don't want to talk about the forge just yet. Let's lump the forge in with the metalworking. So we'll come back to that. Let's talk about construction. So as I said, craftsmanship is just this really misguided skill. And the problem with construction is that it solves things that aren't important. For example, one of the things it does is it lets you build faster, but buildings already construct at a relatively good speed. Like, yes, if you have bad morale, it can take a little longer to construct a building, but once all of your buildings are finished, you don't care about faster building anymore. And then in addition to that, to really get faster building speed, first you have to build a staging area. And then so you got to spend time building the staging area. Then you got to spend time activating the staging area's abilities that speed up construction. And by the time you do that, your base is probably a 1/3, maybe 40% built. So it takes forever just to activate the faster building speed, and just having a higher morale is a much easier way to speed up the construction process. And once your base is maxed out, well, it's no longer useful. It's not like the facilities that can train your character's skills, because, you know, you could realistically get another character and need to train it. And also, if you've got 8 characters that need training, it'll take way, way longer to train up all 8 characters' skills than it would to build up the base. You could build several bases in the time that it would take you to, like, max out the skills of 8 characters. So building faster, it's just not important. So another thing that makes construction just this really misguided skill is that it has this whole, its main thing. The main thing construction does is upgrade your storage. And that's, storage stinks. Storage is not an important stat. Basically, once you get to the level 2 storage, so you have 25 storage globally, this is before the buff. We'll talk about the buff later. The buff to storage, that is. That's enough storage because there are other solutions to storage. If you have, the fuel's a really easy way to explain it. If you hit the cap on the 25 fuel cap, and I've got more fuel. Well, what do you do? Well, one thing you could do is just make more gasoline canisters, because that's something that you would have used anyways. So you can turn all of your excess fuel into gasoline canisters. That's a perfectly reasonable thing to do. You could also make weapons. You need more Molotovs. Do you need more fuel bombs? Do you need to make pyro launcher ammunition? It doesn't matter if you have an overflow of fuel, because there's other things that you can spend it on. And even if you don't want to do that, what do you do in the event that, I'm hitting the storage capacity on fuel. What do I do? I don't know. Put it in your van. The van has 8 slots, 9 if you upgrade it into an apocalypse van. You just store it in your van. You don't need the extra storage. And this has been true since the very beginning of the game. It's why storage isn't good. And so you've got this skill where the big thing it does is lets you get to level 3 storage, store even more materials. Woo, big deal. And then it lets you build mods that increase your storage, which, once again, who wants to insert mods into your facilities to get more storage when you can just A, put the rucksacks in a vehicle trunk, or B, just use them for something, like make med kits, make ammo, make fuel canisters. It's just such a misguided skill because you just don't need storage. And I just feel like Undead Labs don't get that, because in Providence Ridge, they added yet another base that gives you plus 100 fuel storage. You would just never need that. I feel like they just have this imagining that the way people would deal with daily resource losses is by having a huge capacity. Like, I don't know, let's say you're losing 10 fuel a day. I feel like the way they think you are going to deal with it is by claiming a base with 100 extra fuel storage and then be like, well, if I lose 10 fuel a day, good thing I have this storage thing, because Now it'll take 10 days for me to run out of fuel. Except no one is going to play that way. The way people play is to reduce their daily fuel upkeep. It's to be more sustainable. So it just makes construction, it's just so bad. Like, construction is probably the worst fifth skill of the core fifth skills, the ones that you actually advance into out of all of them. Now, what about metalworking? So metalworking seems like it's okay. The problem is that it's been obsoleted by other features. So what metalworking does now, this is where we're going to talk about the forge. Metalworking unlocks all the features of the forged. But the problem is that everything that the forge does is basically useless now. So you've got the CNC mill. The CNC mill does the main thing that the forge does, but without needing a forge. So the primary feature of the forge is that you can put in materials and it'll smelt them down and give you parts at a much better rate than going to the storage room and activating the ability to convert materials to parts. Well, the CNC mill has the same conversion rate. It doesn't have as big of a batch size, so you have to activate it more frequently. But honestly, that's not a big deal because you don't need a fifth skill to activate the CNC mill. You can plug it into your everyday workshop. And on top of that, the forge uses up fuel in order to actually smelt the, what do you call it, the materials into parts. So basically the CNC mill just poops all over the forge. It's like, well, why would you ever want that when you've got a CNC mill? Then you've got the idea that the forge can build weapons. Well, too bad. You know, those weapons could be decent, especially the rebar blade, but we just so happen to add even better weapons that are easier to get on the bounty brokers. So they just add weapons in that poop on the much more important forge. Like, the forge requires a fifth skill, an advanced fifth skill, to fully activate. You gotta have metalworking to activate it, and that should be good. It should be an important thing, but they have other features in the game that make the forge useless. And they do it. The CNC mill was always in the game, but they added in the bounty broker, and so they added in things that make their own far more important things. Their fifth skills, their facilities, they added things that make them useless. So that's really the reason why craftsmanship and its two advanced skills stink. It's like you just never would want those because they either A, they don't solve an important problem, no one needs storage, or they do something that seems cool, except there are better alternatives to it. So it's just, it's really, really frustrating. And so I already talked about the kind of the next subject. You know, how is Undead Labs making this worse? So I already talked about how they're adding in weapons that are basically like undermining the forge. But it's not just that. Another example of that is that they added in a universal upgrade to storage capacity. So all storage now have plus 10 more. So the level 1 storage room originally had 15 storage. And so now they bumped it up by 10. So now level 1 storage has 25, level 2 storage has 35, and then level 3 has 60 storage to the specific type that you upgraded it to. So like the fire safe storage will now have 60 fuel and 60 ammo storage. So they just made this a global upgrade. Why would you do that? Now you've made craftsmanship and construction even worse. The whole point of construction was to make storage more accessible. But now you've made storage even worse by just globally making storage more accessible. Why would you do that? If you're going to make storage bigger, why not attach that to construction? Why not make it where if you have a character with construction, you just, as long as you have that character, you just get plus 10 storage globally. Why not do that and make that skill at least a little bit better? It still wouldn't be good. It would still be a bad skill. It would not be worth having just for plus 10 storage. But the reverse situation is you wanted to make things more convenient to players because you're like, oh my God, we're so apparently players were inconvenienced only having 15 storage. Well, that's the point of the fifth skills. The point of the fifth skills is to grant you greater conveniences. So why are you making your skills worse when the fifth skills are, that's their purpose. Their purpose is to make the game more convenient by strategic choice of the skills. Oh my God, really, It really drives me nuts. And then, yeah, like as I said, with the other thing they do is they, so they add this bounty broker who you get weapons, like the high angle rescue hatchet is a great example. The ice axe is another one. The high angle rescue hatchet was from the critical response and the ice axe is from the bundle up pack. Both of those are just so much better than the rebar blade, and they're easier to obtain. You just have to throw influence at it, and you don't need a fifth skill. You don't need the forge, and bam, you can just have them. And they're better, too. They're just strictly better. The high-angle rescue hatchet, it was the rebar blade with better stats. It didn't have any disadvantages. So, once again, they act like, hey, guys, look at all these cool weapons we're adding into the game. Well, too bad you are undermining the drastically more important core mechanics of the game for your quote-unquote cool weapons. So that's really the issue we're looking at. So we got this idea that the game's going on 2 years old. You've got these skills that they were misguided from the beginning, or they're being basically undermined by decisions from Undead Labs. So how do we fix this problem? How do we turn things around? How do we make craftsmanship better? Well, the first thing you can do is just stop undermining your game. Stop adding conveniences that could be attached to fifth skills. Instead of globally adding 10 storage, add that to construction. Instead of just making all cars have double their fuel capacity, make that exclusive to apocalypse vehicles so that auto mechanics and the auto shop have more value. You can make the game more convenient, but give it to the fifth skills that are really important to your game. The next thing, stop adding weapons that undermine your own game. Don't add weapons that are just easier to get and better than weapons in the forge. And also, why are the forge weapons? A lot of them are just not good. Anyway, we'll get to that. So that's what Undead Labs can just do in terms of just stopping things. Just stop making your core features worse. What can we do to make construction better specifically? Well, I already said that add the plus 10 storage bonus to construction. So here's the thing. The problem with construction is that nothing it does is important. So what it needs is completely new features. It needs brand new mechanics. And here's my ideas. First one, new ability. Got to have construction do it. It's called professional installation. It's available to every single facility that is not built in. So what it does is, it takes a long time to do. So like, this is something where like, it takes an entire game day to do one facility. But what it does is it turns it into a built-in facility. Now you can tear it down if you want, but what it basically does is remove the one material a day upkeep cost. My idea here is get rid of the staging area. The staging area is butting into construction's realm. So get rid of the staging area and let construction be the skill that removes material upkeep. The construction guy, this guy comes into your base and he's like, look, you built this rickety piece of crap thing because none of you know how to use power tools. Let me show you how it's done. He comes in there and professionally installs all of the stuff, and he builds it so well that it doesn't have a material cost anymore. But it takes a very long time to do. So if you've got a really big base, it'll take a long time. It takes even longer with large facilities, for example. My next ability is going to be called custom housing. So what this does is the construction expert is able to add a generic facility mod slot to any facility that doesn't have a mod slot. It's a permanent installation. It takes a very, like a whole game day for him to add this facility slot in, but any facility that doesn't have one, like I'm pretty sure like crafting stills or brewing stills don't have slots, he can add one to it. And then it's a generic slot, so you can put like a comfy chair in there or something. And once again, it's going to take a long time to do, but it's this idea that you're inviting this guy who's an expert at like building up your house. Like in the apocalypse, you'd think that in a game we're building up a base, you'd think that building a guy who knows how to build things and use power tools and stuff, you'd think he'd be pretty useful. So the next ability I came up with is called home improvement. And all these abilities are just going to be extra icons on each facility. So what home improvement does is, same kind of concept, it takes a long time to upgrade. You can only do one facility at a time, but when you're done, it adds a small morale bonus because now it looks really nice. He's interior decorating, just makes it look super nice, super polished, doesn't look ghetto anymore. So it adds a small morale bonus to each facility you do it to. And then there's a facility action speed bonus because everything is super nice and neat. It's organized. It's got like all the proper tools, you know, like all the, like if it was done to like a kitchen, you could imagine you would go out and get like, you know, really nice pots and pans. You'd go out and you'd go get like a new appliances you're installing and everything. And he's just like just pimping your house out with these awesome things. And like I said, it takes a whole day to do it. So this is something that it's like a long-term thing. And it's designed, he's designed to polish your base up. And the last skill I thought of was called Reconstruct Barricade. This would have to be a completely new mechanic to the game. But what he's able to do is repair the base's security fence and remove the holes and the obstructions around the base so that you can have a nice, clean security fence. And it takes a very, very long time to do, and you can't even do the entire fence at a time. You gotta do it like section by section. But I think that's something that players would really like to do. They really want the idea of, you know, I want to make improvements to make my ultimate base, and the wall is a really big part of it. But let's talk about improvements to metalworking. So first off, the forge should be better than the CNC mill. Don't reduce the strength of the CNC mill. Make the forge better than the CNC mill. It should convert parts into, or it should convert materials into parts better than the CNC mill. Then the same thing, but for the salvage furnace. If you have a forge, you should salvage weapons at an even better rate than the salvage furnace. It needs to be better than a mod that doesn't require a fifth skill. You're dedicating a fifth skill here. It needs to be really good. Next, they need to improve the forge weapons, and they can do this. One, give them sensible stats. Some of the weapons are just like better versions of the same thing. Don't do that. If you have one sword that's all about dismemberment, have one sword that's all about lethality, and then have one sword that has a lot of lethality and a lot of dismemberment, but low ease of use. Have one blunt weapon with a lot of impact, like a demo hammer. Have one blunt weapon with a lot of knockdown, and then have one that has both. And where are the two-handed weapons? Get some two-handed weapons in that furnace, or in the forge, rather. Like, that's what these things should be all about. Should be making these really awesome weapons. Another idea, bounty broker. Get some exclusive blueprints from the bounty broker that lets you build unique things only in the forge while the bounty is available until it cycles out. So add in some bounty broker synergy, but even more ideas. I like the idea of when skills combo. Do you remember I talked about how to get the strong painkillers? You need a trader skill, the trader leader. You need pharmacology and you need medicine. Well, here's my idea. Get metalworking, knowledge of metalworking, and knowledge of engineering. Knowledge of engineering and metalworking, and it unlocks gunsmithing. So you can make melee weapons in the forge. You can make guns in the forge by combining an engineer and a metal worker. Really awesome. Make different kinds of, like, you know, do-it-yourself guns or whatever, all kinds of stuff like that. That would be really awesome. And engineering is a skill that it's not super great. That would make it even better. Another combo, metalworking and auto mechanics unlock car chopping and salvaging. What it does is you can drive a car into one of your parking spaces, then you go to your forge, and then you can select a car out of the car parking space. It takes like a whole day to do it, but they can chop and beat up this car, scrap it down, and you get a whole bunch of different stuff. Because I want to add in a new feature into the game, the ability to add mods to your cars. So your apocalypse vehicle will now have like mod slots, and you can slot in the specific customizations you want. You want more fuel capacity? Bam, you can do it. You want like an awesome like surround sound, like stereo, which improves the morale of everybody driving in it? You can do that. You want like comfy chairs? You know, you want to add like nitro or something? You want like off-road capability? You chop cars that you don't want, and you don't know what mod. Well, if you chop up like a Jeep, maybe you get things related to like better suspension and stuff like that. You chop up like a truck, maybe you can get like a better truck bed or something. But you chop up cars to get mods. mods, and that makes auto mechanics more interesting, and it works well with metalware. Look at this, this combo synergy of making these skills much more interesting, and there's more fun, there's more customization, there's more thinking about like what kind of like awesome apocalypse vehicle you want. But another one, we're going to add in a new ability called Reinforce the Defenses. So just like how construction can repair the security fence, metalworking can add defenses onto it. So you could start adding on barbed wire to the sections that don't have it. You can add on reinforced doors that are harder for the zombies to bash open. And another combo skill, if you have metalworking and construction, you're able to build spiked barricades. Surround your entire base with these spike barricades. And what happens is when the zombies attack, they will impale the first few zombies that attack the base, and they basically like start to gunk up the pike wall, and eventually when enough bodies amass, they can climb over them, because like basically now there's nothing poking out if they're covered in zombie bodies, and that will allow them to eventually climb over the defenses. Now, you'd probably have to nerf barbed wire, because like it wouldn't be fair if there was no entrance in. So what you could do now is zombies can climb over barbed wire, but they take damage. Like the barbed wire rips them up a bit, it damages them. And like that's what you could do. That once again, awesome synergy between the construction and the metalworking, and you're building more of your zombie dream base, which is that's one of the things you want to do. You want to have this awesome community that builds your zombie dream fortress. And why not have these skills that have been kind of like left behind because they don't do important things, make them more useful? And that's really what I wanted to talk about in this idea. This whole idea that you've got these fifth skills. They're so, so important to the game. They're like, they're really central to the State of Decay 2 experience. And they're just, they're falling behind. They're being neglected. And they just can't be bad. It's so important that these skills are not bad. They don't have to be like God tier, but they can't be bad. And they need to solve problems in the game. And if those problems don't exist, then you need to create them. The skills, if there's just nothing for them to do, that's an indicator that you need to come up with new mechanics for them to have important problems to solve. And all of the conveniences that they're adding, they're ruining their skills by globally adding conveniences that could be strengthening these poor fifth skills that just really need help. And I don't know, that's just really what bothers me. And that's why I decided to make this skill. And in the end, let's just face it, if a skill doesn't solve a meaningful problem, it gets ignored. And that's just so terrible. Like, why have such important skills just be ignored because they aren't good? Let me know what you think down in the comments section, though, because you know what I think? What would you do to make craftsmanship better? Do you agree? Do you think craftsmanship is bad? Maybe you don't. Maybe you love craftsmanship. Let me know what you think down in the comment section. At any rate, like I said, let me know what you think. Like this video if it was interesting. Subscribe for future State of Decay 2 content. Of course, remember that you don't have to be good to get good.